Group is pleased to present Krazy Kirk and the Hillbillies.
Thank you! Howdy!
Howdy!
So glad to see, I see some people came back again, yet again, to see two shows in a row, but we only do two shows in a day. We sure appreciate that. We expect you to come to every show we do, and I've been able to make eye contact with every single person already. Okay, now I have. Ow! Let me just hear the wagon, people! Ow! That's the wild wagon right there. That's terrible. They're going to take that wagon out of here. Sometimes that wagon tends to roll off the end there, so don't move around, don't jiggle. And that one there falls forward, so don't lean forward, whatever you do in that wagon. Stay back, lean back. I'm kidding. We have made a lot of friends over the years. Good to see people that we've known for so many years, and we've made new friends, new people, that since we've been here. I'm just curious, though, how many first-timers out there that's never seen us? How many first-timers? Not very many, just a few of you. How many people have seen us? Well, that's just fantastic. Well, that's the only reason we have a job. So you keep coming and seeing us, or we might lose our job. I have to put it to you like that, so it's on your backs. And feel free, you can leave early if you want. If you want to come down and see a show, just if you have time for a few songs, feel free to do that, but I might make fun of you as you walk out. Don't take it personally. I get to work with this guy there. That guy with that fiddle, that's Dynamite Benny. This fellow right here, Animal Anders. Whistling Rick on the banjo. And we came from another place, another land, with various characters, with princesses and whatnot. And then we ended up here at Knott's Berry Farm, and this is the truth. I've never had more fun on any stage in my life than I've had here at Knott's Berry Farm. And we get to pay tribute to certain characters. Thank you. There's Charlie Brown walking around here. There's Linus, there's Lucy, and of course, Snoopy.
Score, aim and die, trying to end that spree of the blood.
Storey. All right, people. We've turned any song into a country song. Any kind of song makes a good bluegrass song. Let's do it with this old rock and roll song. I know y'all recognize the summertime blues. Saturday, Sunday, Monday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, Monday, Monday, Monday. So make sure that you tell all your friends over here. And this is such a great setup. I love this plane outside here. It's kind of like I've got a concert feeling to it. And so let's do another song. Let's bluegrass another tune. Let's do this one to the letter. Thank you. I brought the teeth. I know some people like go, where's the teeth? And they get up and they leave early because they expect these stupid teeth. And so I just want you to know they're here and they're in my pocket, and there will be a moment of clarity with those teeth, but not right this second. What we'd like to do right now is put Rick on a different instrument. He's going to play that Telecaster guitar. It gives us a different sound. We have been known also to play with drums. So you might see a drummer now and then here when we're playing outside. I'd like to remind everybody we're here. Please hold it down. I want to remind everybody that we're here Friday, Saturday, Sunday, and Monday. So make sure you tell all your friends. And we do songs like this. This is one song we sent a tribute out to a lady that was here on the 4th of July. She was from England, and so it made this song really awkward. Chilly, kind of cold. That's a good fire for what we need for the last song of this set, which will be The Devil Went Down to Georgia. Yes, and we use this as this is kind of sets the mood for the way we do that particular song. But let's do this one in the key of A. Let's open the gate and walk them on in, boys. I'm inclined to start the bidding at 25. Bidding 25, got a 30, bidding on a 30, go 35, bidding on a 40. Got a 40, bidding on a 40, got a 40, bidding on a 40, got a 40, bidding on a 40, got a 40, 40. Well, I got a 40, I got a bidding on a 0. Was that you? There was boy. from Arkansas who listened to the mom. She told him that he should go to school. We'll sing away in the afternoon. We might go walk the pretty soon. You'll find them at the local auction barn. It's in listen carefully. And then pretty soon he began to see how the auctioneer could talk so rapidly. But he said, oh my, it's tonight. I got over and up the crack. Gonna make my mark and be an auctioneer. $25 bid now for another
thank you.
a sound, that means it's time for us to do a certain song that Rick is going to sing. And that particular song, I'll tell you what that is, if you're just a little patient. Somebody thinks they're watching TV. Somebody, I'm just kidding. No, we appreciate it. This is a good song that Rick's going to sing for us called, I was going to say the Wheelhouse, called Just Passing Through. In their pocket that it communicates with satellites. So a band has become kind of a who cares. But seeing all of you folks hanging with us as long as you have means a whole lot to us. Thank you very much, you guys. And thank you, Knott's Berry Farm. And since you've been such a good audience and relatively, just kidding, you've been a wonderful audience, and I think that you deserve a moment with the teeth. Okay, and those of you who have not seen the show, this is something that I don't enjoy at all. This is I think it's cheap. I think it's a cheap way to get a laugh. There's no really backstory to it. There's no real reason for it. It's like, you know. But here we go for you people that care so much about this part of the show. I want you to want me. I want you to want me. Sing a song for these people, that the rain song about
from up there.
Or actually, I've asked Rick, would you like to see Rick do the high ball?
Yeah!
Yeah, I want to see you do it. No, you don't, Rick. No. That's dangerous, y'all.
There's a chain. I can't get up the stairs. There's a security chain.
Oh, there is your chain. We
can't get up.
So you can't do that then, okay?
No, I can't. It's impossible.
All right, we'll work on seeing if we can get that chain. We're here tomorrow, so maybe we'll have that chain removed for Rick to do the high fall. But till then, there's a beautiful song that I'm... Is it okay if you do the... Have you ever seen the rain? It's a beautiful song that Rick's going to sing for us right now called Have You Ever Seen the Rain?
Sunny day.
of the show. So we, and that means teeth, and that means devil went down to Georgia. But we need to work this song in, and we can work it in only if we do a fast version of it. So let's do an up-tempo version of Love Me Tender. Theatrically using theatrics. The storyteller, or what we've referred, you're going, all right. The storyteller, or what we like to refer to as the teller of the story, will be performed by none other than Rick Storey. We have so many characters in this piece, the way we've arranged it. We need Anders to be not double cast, but quadruple cast. I want you to play various characters in the city. Not a city, but a village. A small village in the Appalachian Mountains in the 1500s. And one of the guys has got a bit of a hunch on his back. One of these. Then I want you to drop those characters and become evil demon musician. Animal Anders, ladies and gentlemen. Playing the most difficult, demanding character in the piece. Fortunately, we had the most difficult, demanding member in our band to play the role of the villain, Dynamite Eddie! I cast myself as the lead. Thank you. It was kind of weird, but thank you. I'm going to try to perform this piece. I'm going to try to perform this heroically. I'm going to be trying to heroically be kind of a rugged cowboy. But, I wish you wouldn't play that groove because that makes me do this with my hips. And that's not at all what we're trying to get at. You're going to want to clap right when you hear the melody because you recognize the melody, but we ask you to wait until I give you a cue to lift the end of the song. Also, every single time we have performed this piece, we have received a standing ovation. And thanks, and let's thank the family for waiting, this family waiting for us. I hope it's worth it. You better be there at the end of this, though, I must say. If you leave in the middle of this is going to be just horrible for us at our age. I don't know if we can handle that.
He was looking for a soul to steal. He was in a bind, he was willing to make a deal. When he came across this young man, sawing on the fiddle and playing it hot, why the devil jumped up on a hickory stump and said,
"Boy, let me tell you what. Well, I guess you didn't know it, but I'm a fiddle player too. And if you care to take a dare, I'll make a bet with you. Now you play pretty good fiddle, son, but give the devil his due. I'll let a fiddle of gold against your soul, because I think I'm better than you."
The boy said,
"My name's Johnny. And it might be a sin, but I'll take your day, you're going to regret, because I'm the best that's ever been.
Johnny, rise up, you bow.
So stupid.
When the devil finished, Johnny said,
"You're a pretty good old son. Yep. So sit down in that chair right there and let me show you how it's done."
He played Fireman one more night.
Try again. I told you once, you son of a gun, I'm the best of several.
He played!